have Dave Thomas, a physicist and mathematician, come and present the other side. And so we did that, and it was very, this is written up on our website. In fact, we've just gotten the video of the event, and I haven't even seen it yet. I've got to see that. But we'll post it on our website. And so I give a presentation of our side for half an hour, followed by his side, Dave Thomas. And now Sherry Bernson, executive producer of KVDI Public Television in Denver, has invited us to come back. We already did a pledge drive with her where she aired Blueprint for Truth, The Architecture of Destruction, our DVD, to 200,000 people in Colorado. We're going to come back in March on the 20th and do this live debate during their pledge drive. And once again, they'll have Blueprint for Truth as a pledge premium. And we'll have an interactive. They'll play a little bit of the DVD, and then I'll present the main points, and Dave Thomas will have an opportunity to refute them. And we'll go back and forth for up to 2 hours. So it's a wonderful opportunity to, you know, get all of this, both sides, on publicly aired television and recorded, of course, on a DVD. So that we can, you know, kind of present both sides. Here's what we say, and here's what...
That's very, very exciting. Very exciting.
Their own mind. Yeah.
Yeah, no, that's great. And all the time we're getting a chance to hone our arguments and to learn, and we can see what people are throwing at you, and we learn to you know, things that we can say on the street and how they're going to be attacked. But it's a learning process, this campaign for 9/11 Truth, and this is going to be a very interesting experience for you, and I can't wait to see it. Anyway, now you're also attending something else that's very, very exciting in my view, which is on March 6th and 7th. You're going to be speaking at this treason conference. I can't think of the name exactly, but basically it's peace activists, military experts, who we really need on our side, and the police, and all the people you know, that work for us within the government that aren't, you know, part of the political structure, and 9/11 truth advocates all coming together at this treason conference, which just sounds too good to be true. I'm really impressed.
Yes, it's called Treason in America. It's in Philadelphia, and it's I've got the date right here.
6th and 7th of March, I think.
7th.
Yep.
Yeah. We're very excited. We'll be presenting the science-based forensic evidence for the destruction of these three skyscrapers on 9/11. It's going to be good.
It'd be good to see Jesse Ventura there, but yeah, I haven't heard that he's going, but he would suit that event very well, considering the people that we've got there, the military people as well. I think it's a really good sign for the movement. Obviously, we've seen the peace movement come close to 9/11 Truth a few times and then back away for different reasons, but let's hope this time that we start to build a real and lasting bond with them, because you know, without truth you can't have justice, and without justice you definitely can't have peace. And you know, some of us have been very frustrated with peace activists over the years because they've refused to you know, take the adversarial position on 9/11, and we hope more of them will, that's for sure. Now the last question, and then we'll talk about your press conference, if you can give us some more details about that, is when you're in Australia, we talked about 911truth.org. I know that you had some discussions here with Luke and Cosmos and Janice Matthews, etc., about sort of 911truth.org. Now, I just wanted, I know that you think that site's very important because it's the first site that we get hits at when people search for 9/11 Truth. Now, I'm just wondering if you know, architects and engineers for 9/11 Truth value that site and sort of, you know, I hope to see them support the site.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. If we did what to the site, though?
Just support it. Do you value it? Value the site?
Yeah, we're financial supporters of 9/11 Truth. And,
excellent.
And Janice in particular, and it's absolutely critical that all of us come together. And I don't know why there's been a shortage of support for her and that site, and its board. But it's extremely important that we all show up and pitch in, because it is an umbrella for all of us. You know, like you said, it's the first place people come to. Most of them, 9/11 Truth. It's extremely important, and it's a solid site.
And there's no disinfo there, which is great.
They draw the line.
Excellent. Well, would you like to tell us a little bit more about the press conference coming up and any other future events and plans you have for architects and engineers for 911 Truth? And obviously, you have a board there. That maybe you could expand on that a little bit. Maybe some people don't realize architects and engineers is not just Richard Gage anymore, is it? There's a board.
Well, right. Yeah, we have a 7-member board, and we meet every week for 2 hours, and we've got a lot of work to do. Right now we're putting in an application for a 501c3 status with the IRS. We'll be able to take tax-deductible donations. It's quite an organization. We have over 30 volunteers who give at least 10, most of them 20 hours a week, some of them 40 hours a week. It's really quite an operation. We have 20 conference calls per week, and have anything from the graphics, marketing, finance, web team, verification of our structural engineers. These are all 1-hour conference calls, and I'm on every one of them. So half of my time every week, half of a 40-hour week is on those calls. I work more like 60 or 70 hours a week, unfortunately.
Mm.
But it never stops. Yeah, but the board hires me, and they can fire me. So we're very careful about who's on our board and how dedicated they are. And all of them are giving at least 20 hours a week volunteer time, and many of them at great personal sacrifice. It's a wonderful organization, and we're so proud of what we've been able to accomplish over the last 3.5 years, culminating in 1,000 signatories now, which we're going to take to Congress in February, and the press conference will release that. The press conference is on February 26th, we believe right now. It might be the 19th, but we're hoping to do it at the AIA office, and wherever it will be, it will be big. We're spending $2,000-$3,000 at least on publicity for this, local, national, and international publicity, so that there's no opportunity for people, at least the media outlets and Congress, to know that there's 1,000 technical professionals calling for a real investigation, and we think that number somehow will mean something to them. We hope it will. I mean, how many does it really take? It only takes one speaking the truth, but we haven't gotten the attention. Maybe 1,000 will.
No, so basically you're putting that press release on the wire, which we did in Australia, which basically, you know, sends it by a reputable source to all the media organizations, and they pay attention to it because it's a paid press release, professional press release, isn't it?
Yes, and that's true. And we'll have a dinner where we'll get together and have some speakers here in San Francisco, and we're inviting all of our petition signers shortly to that when we finalize the details. And we'll have a conference for architects and engineer petition signers the next morning. So we hope, 30 or 40 at least, we'll be able to come for that event. We'll find out what their interests, what's keeping them from being active. What are they doing that others could be inspired by in the way of speaking this truth and doing research and publicizing and writing? There's so many different things that can be done.
There's in my whole life, and I've you know, played in rock bands and you know, done all sorts of sporting things. There's nothing more engaging in every attribute than 9/11 Truth. It's absorbing, but it's also extremely engaging, and it can be a lot of fun. Like, we had a great time in New Zealand. That was just that night we went out. We were surrounded by journalists and artists and very interesting people. I've made some of my best friends that I've ever found in my whole life through 9/11 Truth, and you know, people should get out and get involved. There's nothing, like you said, no one's threatening us. You know, if, as long as you're out there and you're proud and you're doing the right thing, you know, there's nothing to fear but, you know, fear itself, and that's really the truth. And, well, thank you, Richard. It's been an absolute excellent interview. I've really, really enjoyed talking to you. I haven't had any sleep for 28 hours, but that's another story. I was on night shift last night. But
yeah,
I know you've been burning the candle. And if anyone doesn't know, Richard is very fit man. He looks after his body, looks after his health, and even though he puts himself through the ringer, that's for sure. And I know that you've just been working so hard on this campaign, and I get a tear in my eye. You know, I just think how proud I am what you're doing and how much hope you've given me, Richard, and you've given this movement. So good on you, and please keep up the hard work, and we'll say goodbye. This is Visibility 911. I'm your host, John Bursell, and we thank Richard Gage for coming on the program. We hope to have him back soon, and please support Architects and Engineers for 911 Truth. That's www.ae911truth.org. They're looking for funds right now to help them with their publicity for their 1,000 architects and engineers now they have. And please step up to the plate and do your bit. If you can't get on the street, if you're you know, too fearful to step out in public, put your money in your pocket. Do the right thing. Thanks, Richard. We'll talk to you again soon.
Thank you, John. It's been awesome. We'll catch up with you real soon.
Thanks, mate. Bye-bye.